Sicilien är den största ön som ligger i Medelhavet, och när man tänker på Sicilien så kanske man tänker på sol och bad. Man kanske tänker på Etna, en aktiv vulkan. Du kanske tänker på Cosa Nostra, eller så tänker du på vin. I den här serien som vi har som heter Smaka på så har vi gjort 3 avsnitt härifrån Sicilien, så är ni redo? Nu kör vi! Nu smakar vi på Sicilien!
I det här avsnittet så ska vi besöka Mandrarossa. Och Mandrarossa hittar vi i Menfi som ligger på västkusten på Sicilien, och det ingår i kooperativet Cantina Settesoli.
And by this map we can have a better idea about the territory.
Det här är Roberta, och det är hon som är PR-ansvarig, och hon är en av de som ska guida runt oss här idag.
Okay. So where we are exactly now? We are in Menfi. And this is Mandrarossa Winery, a new building, a sustainable building, born last year, exactly 22 June 2021, we opened it. And this is like a window on the territory. So there is the sea in front of us. And by this window, we can have a better idea about how sustainable, how rich of biodiversity is our territory. Because we have different slopes, altitudes, expositions, and 5 different kind of soil. This is a corner of Sicily like a paradise, because it's far from the crowded beaches and for the full of traffic cities, big cities of the island. This is the district. The district name is Terre dei Sicani. Menfi is the biggest town of the area, but around there are few villages: Sambuca di Sicilia, Conte Sentellina, Santa Margherita di Belice and Montevago. And our vineyards goes to Sciacca. Sciacca is a town in the province of Agrigento. Menfi is in the province of Agrigento, like Santa Margherita, Montevago and Sambuca as well. But Contessa is in the province of Palermo, because the territory across 3 provinces: Agrigento, Palermo and Trapani. To west, okay. To east. Okay, so the sea is very important for our terroir, because the sea breezes effect refresh the vineyards, refresh leaves, refresh plants. Also, we have a lake, the Lago Arancio, is close to Sambuca di Sicilia, and our vineyards are around the lakes. The lake as well. And then we have a river, the Belice River, that across the valley. So the name of the valley is Valle del Belice. Also, each color means a different soil consistency. So 5 kind of soils. So this is a medium mixture, for example, but also we have red soils that is sandy. The white soil is chalky, so limestone. Then we have the yellow, straw yellow soil, that is clay. And when it's dark, is a mix. So for a long time, for more than 25 years, long time ago, we mapped this territory to understand the better combination to soil and grape varietals. In the past, when Mandrarossa born in 1999, we produced only 7 grape varietals. But now, for Mandrarossa, we are producing 17 different grape varietals, just in Menfi, excluding the Etna and the Pantelleria grapes, because we are producing wines from Menfi, so Sicilia DOC wines or IGT Terre Siciliane, but also wines from Etna, Etna DOC, and from Pantelleria, Pantelleria DOC. In total, because the company name is Cantine Settesoli and we are a community of growers, we are producing 36 different grape varietals.
How many growers and how many?
In total, the company have 2,000 of growers that manage 6,000 hectares of vineyards. For Mandrarossa, we have selected 175 growers that take care of 500 hectares. Usually, we will pick the Sauvignon Blanc grapes end of July, and this is a night harvest.
Oh, in July. Så skördesäsongen är alltså hur lång som helst här. De börjar i slutet på juli och skördar Sauvignon Blanc för att det är så varmt här och det behövs behålla fräschören och syran i just den druvan. Det är coolt.
It's very interesting to visit us during the harvest time because all the family, all the local people all around their own vineyards picking the grapes. Generation by generation, the harvest time is like a party for the community. They work hard, but it's very, very, they are very proud to be part of this community, the community of Cantine Sette Soli.
Innan vi fortsätter runt turen på vineriet så stannar vi till i köket. Och där träffar vi Mandrarossa Kitchen Brigade.
So I can help you.
ora.
Mandrarossa Brigado.
Lady Kitchen Brigade.
Lady Kitchen Brigade startade 2012. Och det är alltså ett helt gäng med nonnas som lagar mat. Och vi ska äta mat här med dem idag. Det är det hon håller på att förbereda där.
Now they are preparing the involtini. Mm. Pork meat with cheese, pistachio, and salt and pepper inside. You can buy them in a supermarket, but this is homemade, so the taste is totally different.
Ok.
Ok. Poi cerchiamo di piegare un pochettino i bordi. Bene, brava. E poi arrotoliamo.
And roll. Brava. Would you try to prepare the pasta?
Of course.
Okay, this is one of the most popular, the cavatelli. Today, Rosa and Annella prepared the broccolo. Broccolo riminato.
Lavoriamo la pasta.
Press.
Ci vuole forza.
Yes,
e poi la sottigliamo.
Vilken deg!
Così, con questa misura. E tagliamo la misura di tre dita.
Vai momento.
Ascolta, vai solo da questo lato, da un lato soltanto, mm-hmm, così.
Mm-hmm.
Ok, taglia. Ok, prende il pezzettino, si mettono le dita in questo modo.
Take your fingers, three fingers.
Si imprime molta forza per dargli questa
molta
forma.
Molta forza.
Brava.
Sì.
This is the simple pasta.
Damerna här, de visar tekniken för flera olika pasta som jag får vara med och göra. Och degen består av duren vete och vatten och den är alldeles silkeslen. De använder alltså inte ägg i pastadegen här på Sicilien historiskt och det ligger liksom kvar.
You're so quick.
Il buso.
Take your buso.
Quello di legno. Però questo è quello originale di metallo.
Di non press too much. Very delicate.
Guarda. Così.
I did press, sorry.
Piano piano.
Impresso.
Put on your fork and press.
E si arrotola.
Press and roll. Press and
roll. Forte, sempre
now,
forte.
Now. Oh wow!
Brava!
Brava, come è stata?
Bravissima!
Annella och Rosa förbereder här ett traditionellt bakverk från Sicilien. Det är en cannoli och den är fylld med sötad ricotta och toppad med pistagenötter.
Nu har vi fått höra precis vad vi ska äta till lunch här, så nu börjar vi bli riktigt hungriga allihopa.
Lunchen smakar ju extra gott naturligtvis eftersom jag faktiskt har varit med och format pastan. Och till lunchen så provar vi några av Mandrarossas viner som vi hittar i Sverige. Bland annat så har de en serie som är helt druvren och då med Nero d'Avola, Frappato, Grillo och Sibibbo.
abroad.
It's still snow in Sweden.
Oh, well, no snow here at least. A bit of wind.
Det här är Giovanni. Han är PR-assistent på Mandra Rosa och är dessutom en väldigt glad prick. Så medan vi promenerar runt mellan tankarna och prästarna är ute på gården så berättar han gärna om Mandra Rosas forskning om kvalitet på deras viner.
So we are now in a more operative and productive area of the winery. For now it's a bit quiet, but during the harvest time it's a lot of things happening here. All the, you know, the pressing of the grapes and the first stage of the aging happen between here and down underground in the winery, where we have also our bottaglia, so where we have our wood barrel and barrique. Of course, these are the big stainless steel tank when we do the majority of our white wines and also some of our red. While in here, you have a more interesting and modern approach that we use in recent time with these concrete tulip containers at controlled temperature. So the temperature inside stays very cold. And we use this concrete tulip just for two wines, part of the Mandra Rosa line, that are part of a big project of research connected with the calcareous soil. It's a Grillo and Nero d'Avola, so one white and one red. Both these wines, in the first stage of their aging process, are put inside this concrete tank. Why? This is a very neutral container, but still, compared to stainless steel, that lets the wine breathe. So there is some exchange of oxygen, but without having the effect of the wood that may arrive from the barrique. So first month, both the Grillo and the Nero d'Avola age inside this concrete tulip at, again, a low temperature, controlled temperature, just for the first month. Then they are moved again inside in big barrels. So not small barrique, but just a big barrel. And both the Grillo and Nero d'Avola. The Grillo is Bertolino Soprano, is the name, 100% Grillo, while the Nero d'Avola is named Terre del Sommacco. Both these wines come from a research dedicated to the calcareous soil, which is the more hilly side of our territory.
So how do you control the temperature? Is it like double?
It's a machine, and there is a basically it's surrounded by the water that goes around, and this cold water that keep the temperature low. See for sure. Different size, of course. So we are experimenting. Before we talk about how, especially with Mandra Rosa, but in general with Cantina Settesoli, we like to keep on experimenting, keep on researching new materials, new approach. In the vineyards and in the winery. This is part of our DNA.
And how long does the fermentation go on?
The first step of fermentation between white and red can be, usually for the white is about 7 days or 10 days, with the red is a bit longer. And then of course the reds also, the maceration with the skin is also a bit longer. Then they stay in this concrete for the white for 6 months and the red for 9 months. Then they move in the wood. So the wine we're producing with these tools are our top quality, top line, became now in Mandra Rosa. And another small but important project in the island of Pantelleria, where we cultivate and produce the Pantelleria DOC Passito wine. So it's a dessert wine made from the variety Zibibbo, which is again a very aromatic grape variety that just grown this specific genotype just in the Pantelleria Island.
Jag tycker Zibibbo är ett sånt himla coolt namn på en druva. Den går också under ett annat namn, Muscat Alexandria, som man kanske känner till lite mer. Men Zibibbo, jag tycker det låter jättecoolt.
Yeah, of course, Zibibbo is the Sicilian name. Yeah, the Muscat Alexandria.
Now we are going down.
What does this mean?
And this is exactly means la Sicilia che non ti aspetti. So the Sicily you are not expect, you don't expect.
När vi sen fortsätter ner i källaren så visar Giovanni oss några milstolpar för Mandra Rosa. Och där är en av grejerna är att de har fått 90 poäng från Robert Parker för ett av deras viner som heter
Robert
Santanella.
It's a big is the name in this field, so with our Santanella, which is a blend of Fiano and Chenin Blanc, we got 90 points and it was we are very proud of these results.
Ja, det låter lite här inne och det är för att med jämna mellanrum så drar de på lite fukt som gör att faten inte torkar ihop. How big is this one?
It should be the 50 hectoliters.
50 hectoliters. And those are 225?
The barrique, classic barrique.
French oak or?
French oak. French oak, especially for the barrique, second passage, second use. Mm. And then we keep it for 2-3 cycles and then we change it.
Okay.
Nu lämnar vi källaren och så tar vi oss ut i vingårdarna istället och träffar på agronomen Filippo bland vinrankorna.
Okay, so Mandrarossa project started from you knowing what kind of grape to grow in the different soils.
Sì, per esempio, Mandrarossa è nato perché a quel punto ne sapevamo.
Certamente. Quale vitigni mettere nel suolo giusto. Noi abbiamo i suoli Mandrarossa sia nella parte alta che nella parte centrale, ma anche nella parte bassa.
So you happy now or you still experimenting?
Assolutamente di sì, perché in noi e nel nostro DNA studiare, innovare, ricercare e migliorarci sempre. Quindi noi per ora abbiamo in atto uno studio ancora di più sui suoli calcari, iniziato nel 2014 con l'arrivo del nostro consulente Alberto Antonini, che nel suo arrivo siamo fatto un giro nel territorio e lui, essendo un enologo di fama internazionale, ci dice: ma Filippo, voi siete fortunati. Perché? Perché avete i suoli calcari. Dove sui suoli calcari si fanno miglior vino, esempio miglior champagne dove so, è sul suoli calcari, ok? Noi siamo fortunati perché madre natura ce l'ha dato ed ecco che ancora lì nel 2014, ancora tuttora, abbiamo studiato ancora di più i suoli calcari, quindi dalla mappa della zonazione che abbiamo fatto negli anni 70, quindi dal macro terroir, siamo passati come una piramide a stringere, i 500 ettari di Mandrarossa, e stiamo salendo la piramide fino al punto che abbiamo iniziato a fare i vini dai single vigneto, da single vineyard, come il Bertolino Soprano, il Terre del Sommacco, che è proprio un vino che viene solo da un vigneto, perché abbiamo visto che il suolo calcareo è particolare ed è abbastanza presente.
Det är väldigt intressant att få lyssna på Filippo och höra honom berätta hur de jobbar framåt med kvaliteten, hur de tänker när de kartlägger vingården med jordmåner och så vidare. Väldigt, väldigt intressant. Nu är det dags att äta middag. Nu ska vi besöka en restaurang som ligger precis nere vid havet. Den här restaurangen heter Ristorante da Vittorio och som sällskap så får vi med oss Giovanni och hans kollega. Vi har upptäckt att matgästerna gärna tar selfies med den här rustika sicilianska maten. Och då helgrillad fisk i synnerhet. Vi avslutar middagen, kvällen och avsnittet med någonting sött och gott. I nästa avsnitt så ska vi besöka Luisa på den vingård där druvorna odlas för Mandrarossas egna viner. Vinerna produceras och buteljeras även här. Vi bor i den minst sagt kuperade kuststaden Taormina. Och sen får vi se om vi når toppen av vulkanen Etna, som faktiskt är den största aktiva vulkanen i Europa. Tack för att du tittade det här avsnittet. Arrivederci, ciao!
Och det här var tufft. Jag tog i ganska rejält när jag drog molto forza. Så.